Brown. I'm the CEO of Game Sweat Free. We are here to introduce you to our product, Reinforced Grips. Here are our team roles.
My name is Crystal Lopez. I am the Chief Designer Officer.
My name is Charlotte Casada. I'm the Chief Marketing Officer.
My name is Josue Guzman. I am the Chief Financial Officer.
My name is Joaquin Lugan. I'm the other CFO.
Have you ever played video games for a long period of time? If so, your palms can get sweaty and you may be afraid to wipe them because you might die or lose the game. This is a real problem among the gaming community because you just want to play the game and have fun, but it's impossible when your controller keeps slipping. Our product, Reinforced Grips, is a handmade controller grip made from silicone, cornstarch, food coloring, and mint extract. First, we mix everything together. Once we finish mixing everything, we have about 10 or 15 minutes of work time before it hardens. In that time, we mold the mixture to fit the controllers. It comes in different colors depending on the food coloring. It does its job well and lasts long. It only costs $10.
Our target market is boys and girls from 9 to 30. Edgar, this is an example in my school. Edgar's a ninth grader. He's still in school. High school, he likes to play video games, but often gets frustrated when his hands sweat a lot and his controller says, whenever he takes a moment to wipe his hands, he dies or loses. He tried our product, Reinforced Grips, loved them, and he kept his hands from slipping and never lost a game again.
One of our competitors is Exterminate. For Exterminate, their strengths are comfortable, durable, works well. Another competitor is Chinfa. Their strengths are fits well in hand, keeps controller clean, provides perfection. And their weaknesses are not grippy enough, need to remove grip to charge. Game Sweat Free Reinforced Grips would be able to stop control from slipping. Also, they would come in different colors and are handmade.
Our consumer research is we surveyed 10 people from our school using a written form. How much they would pay for the product, 20% said they would pay $15. 20% also said they would pay $10, $10. And then 60% said they would pay $9. And 9 people said they would use our product, and 1 said maybe. Our business values, our mission is to make sure all gamers will always have quality products, and our values are to make a new experience for gamers without having to continuously wipe their hands.
Our cause of good soul. We have 4 items that we use for our products: silicone, foam starch, liquid, and mint. It's about our revenue. I mean, no, to make it is $2.50. And our price is $9.99. But our profit would be $7.83. And our startup cost is $19.12.
Our financial projections, if we sell like our product, we should be able to make around $2.99.70 in revenue. We will also, once we remove the costs and the startup costs, which are $76.80 and $19.12, we should make about $203.78 in profit. We will need $95.92 to start our business, which is adding up the costs and the startup costs. With that money, we should make $299.70 in revenue and break even after selling 10 units.
Thank you for your time. We will now take questions.
Feedback that we provided the first team, like the financials were really well put together, I think. And then not only were they well put together on the slides, you knew the material really well, so you're just kind of sort of flowing with that. So great job there, and I think that in terms of the uniqueness of the product, that it's really unique, and I think it's something, and it's very creative the way you've come up with a very low cost way of achieving, you know, the end product. So overall, great job.
Is there a prototype?
Yeah.
This is the durable one and this is the texture.
Okay.
Yeah, this is
and you don't get a controller here?
So I would maybe point of feedback to either point out sort of, I saw, I know you were sort of holding that at the beginning, sort of letting us all kind of take a look at it, and maybe if the plan was for us to see the prototype at some point, maybe address that and let us sort of see it and hold it and touch it, and while you're giving the presentation, it kind of connects us to your product. Yeah.